So today it's about European sovereignty. So we need to stay independent when it comes to assets. And one of the important things is energy. And that's why I'm here today, and it's a pleasure to meet you. We just toured the facilities, quite impressive. But yeah, give a little background about yourself and your company and what are you doing?
Thanks, Frank, for being here in Slovakia. It's an honor and to host you and your team. So I'm one of the founders of InoBat, and I'm very glad you are here today so we can show you what we've built. I come from a background of being an investor, entrepreneur in the kind of a clean energy infrastructure space, where after years of working in America, Western Europe, and having invested in some of the first clean tech companies, clean energy projects all around the world, whether it was in banking at Lehman Brothers to World Bank, I saw the opportunity to actually bring in a tech innovation to Slovakia.
And come back to your home.
Come back to my homeland, yeah. After 17 years, you know, my dad was always asking, when are you going to come back? And when are you going to do something for the country? Like, you've been working for Americans and Brits and French. What about Slovakia?
So I raised you. Now you have to deliver for the country.
Exactly. Yeah. So, you know, my dad is a bit of a nationalistic guy, very, always cheering on Slovakia at the hockey tournaments, even way too passionate, you know. And I basically saw this calling to come back. I was very lucky that, you know, the country was very welcoming. I thought that, am I going to be another immigrant in my own country after 17 years abroad? But I found incredible people here, supportive public sector, and, you know, we were able to build a company called IPM initially in 2015 that has built a portfolio of technological companies, technological investments, primarily looking for some leading tech companies in Silicon Valley in Western Europe, and look at ways how we can actually marry the world of tech with infrastructure, and basically infra tech, because tech without infrastructure stays in the lab, right? You need to get the product from the mind of the scientists to the customer, and InoBat is one of those companies where we are marrying the IP investments of IPM with the industrialization of high-performance batteries.
And it's so important that we build in Europe infrastructure, that we have our own rockets, our own satellites, our own energy that we will talk about today, the battery factories, because we need that to stay sovereign and to stay independent of China and US. We can have great collaborations, we can learn, I believe we have one world, but also we need an independent, strong Europe, and that's why batteries are so important. And just a little background about how we met. So we met in a very ambitious and I believe a great project that didn't work out as planned, unfortunately, Lilium Aviation. So it was a vertical takeoff landing jet, I believe a great concept with a great founder. And they had to choose a super high-performing battery because when the plane did lift off, they needed a lot of energy. And they did a worldwide screening, and they have chosen InoBat as a supplier. So that speaks for your technology, for the power and energy density that you can deliver. We will talk about. But then you also were excited about Lilium, and you were considering to do an investment and do a finance round that did not work out as expected. So maybe you can give a little background about this.
Yeah, I've been following Daniel Wiegand and his team journey for many years. You know, obviously Lilium has been a great inspiration for any founder who is starting a tech company. Yeah. Their ability to turn an idea from a dormitory at an engineering school to actually a billion-dollar company with $1.5 billion of capital raise. So we're all looking up to them. And I was very glad that at InoBat, we've been working with them and developing a chemistry that has enough energy and power to actually take their technology and eVTOL basically planes vertically
into the sky.
Into the sky, and vertically, and horizontally. This is actually a feat of engineering to do it, and for that you need a strong energy source, and you have to be quiet, no noise, Daniel was always saying that Lilium is like 50 decibels, it's like listening to a washing machine, so the idea that you can have a plane landing anywhere on this green, for example, and not hear it, fantastic, complete replacement for helicopters. So where our teams, InoBat and Lilium, worked together for many years on developing this chemistry. So it was a beautiful union, our engineers, Lilium engineers, and we have been working on developing the chemistry, producing the batteries for their for their battery system. And obviously, when we heard the news about Lilium getting into difficulties, I saw the sadness in the eyes of our team. And you know, coming from the investor world, obviously, this need to rescue got activated. And and without thinking too much about it, I decided to call on my friends and fellow investors to try to help save the company. However, the capital markets were quite tough. Obviously, Europe has been recovering from downfall of Northvolt, so raising capital in such a short period of time proved to be difficult. And you know, I'm very sorry that it didn't work out, and Lilium ended up where it did. You know, it's a fantastic project. I have a lot of respect for the management, for Daniel, and I really hope that the legacy will live with someone else, because the IP has always been unique, and Europe needs this type of innovation to reach the skies.
You're building really batteries that have very unique possibilities. Can you talk a little bit about what is so unique about your technologies, the batteries that you're delivering?
Yeah, we basically, if you want to get people or any equipment vehicle into the air, you need a lot of power to take mm-hmm. off, and a lot of energy to get the distance you need. So for that, you need to really look at the right combination of chemistry and physics. You know, it all starts, I mean, you saw the tour, you know, I always say that making batteries is like making good lasagnas, you know. You need a good recipe, you know, you need to be able to put the ingredients together, but also you need to be able to manage the process so that you have like super thin lasagnas, you know, go through the coating, baking. So in a simplistic terms, making batteries is like making good lasagnas. Yeah. And I think our lasagnas are the best in Europe. That's what customers are saying, because we have the good chemistry, good recipe. We have mastered the industrialization process, you know, so we can go from R&D to production. And you know, our engineers, they work very closely with the engineers on the customer side. You know, basically we co-develop, you know, we kind of customize the right lasagna for the end customer. And I think this is the big difference from the big players in China or Korea or Japan, where we have the ability to really be in the kitchen together, you know, the customer's engineer and our engineers, and we co-design, you know, the right energy source for this very demanding and challenging applications like eVTOLs, drones, you know, for different purposes, infrastructure, transport, or defense. And for that, you need a very unique, super light battery that can give you enough payload mm-hmm. so you can put, you know, people in the air or, you know, different radars, different systems, and enough energy so you can actually carry this load through distance without disrupting the air with too much noise.
So I would get cheaper, much cheaper batteries in China, mm-hmm. but what sets InoBat apart is the power. So I can get a lot of power for planes, for drones, for sports cars or other intense environment. You have a higher density of energy, so I can with fewer weight, I can get more energy inside the plane, the boat, mm-hmm. the drone. Whatever, and then it's about the charging cycles, so yes. that you have more cycles. So you are targeting, is it okay to say that the high end market?
Yeah, I mean we're targeting the ultra high performance manufacturers, so players in aviation, in drone manufacturers, and also ultra high performance EV players. All of these customers, you know, they want to have this degree of distinction, yeah? Mm-hmm. They want to be different, right? You need a degree of differentiation. And in the combustion engine world, you know, the engine was actually what makes you different, right? Yeah. Engine of Ferrari is different than Lamborghini. This was the sense of technical pride and prowess. Now it's really about the battery system, you know? Who's got the best battery technology scores a lot of points with the customer, you know, can solve a lot of problems. Some customers want super fast charge time, so you can be in the air, yeah. you know, quickly, kind of air taxis, you know, yeah. so they can transport as many passengers, do as many trips as possible. Some want life cycles, you know, so they can actually have the longest use and longevity of the product. And some want just, you know, power and energy combined so that, you know, you can carry as many goods for the longest distance. And this is what our chemistry capability allows in this sector.
What's very unique about you is that you really produce in Europe. So we just went through the facilities. So thanks again, very impressive tour.
How did you like it?
Impressive. And you're building here in Europe. So this is made in Europe and not some US players that say, yeah, it's a US battery, but in the end it's from China.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is, maybe you can talk a little bit about that you're really producing in Europe, what are your plans to scale and so on.
So, you know, for me, I have a DNA of an athlete, you know, I'm a former tennis player, so very competitive. I respect my competitors, you know, but I want to win, you know, and so I really wanted Europe and Slovakia as a country to win, you know, in this industry. I'm glad this facility is kind of a stepping stone into that. We are expanding, you know, I showed you our expansion plans. We own the land behind this facility to expand, and I think it's, you know, in life it's important to have degree of control, degree of independence, things you can control. And I think the battery value chain, it's an essential part of the industrial transformation of Europe. Is actually, we need to have it under control. We need to have the ability to control the battery space, the aerospace, you know, because, you know, this is what will make Europe much more competitive compared to America, compared to Asia. And I think this is where we've
been. And also safe. Because I have to say, when it comes to defense, which is unfortunately important, you can't, I believe, you can't rely on Chinese batteries or Chinese or US rockets. So we have our own rockets, we have our own satellites, we have our own battery. It's hard enough to catch up on chips, for example, but we have to see that as kind of the base things of infrastructure are available in Europe, or at least in the NATO region. That's then the next bigger reason. But in batteries, we're basically living out of China, and we have nothing to offer.
I mean, China is obviously, it's part of the evolution, right? They've made a choice 20 years ago not to focus on combustion engines. They left that technical IP to Europeans, and they mastered the battery value chain, right? So they are ahead of us because they really devoted time and money towards this sector. And I always say that, you know, when you are a founder of a company or a aspiring politician, you have to always find a role model, right? Because success leaves cues. And, you know, just as much Chinese have learned from Japanese in the tech or high tech, we now have the ability to learn from them, but also Americans, you know. So what I believe InoBat has done quite well is that, you know, we've been working and collaborating with different tech companies, you know, from Silicon Valley, but also from Asia. But what we made sure is actually that the final product, the final know-how, the final IP is European, right? Because that creates this pebble effect in the country, in the supply chain, and then also on the regional and continental level to really bring this European innovation. But you cannot do it alone, right? If you do it alone, we have many examples of startups who said, okay, I'm European, I'm, you know, super nationalistic, I can, you know, I can do it. But actually, the history taught us a couple lessons recently that it's very difficult, you know, unless you learn from the guys ahead of you. You know, Djokovic has learned a lot from Federer, you know, Federer has learned a lot from Nadal, you know, even Federer has learned from Edberg, you know, because these are actually the legends, you know, and I think we have to have respect for the industry champions. However, try to win your own race as well. I think that's important, not to be afraid to win your own race and enter one. And I think this is what Europe needs, a bit more boldness, and need more courage to do it.
Yeah, that's what I really like. I mean, it's the courage that you see from Emate with Rimac. We're part of Endurosat with Raicho, a great entrepreneur building satellites. You're building the energy. We're building robotic systems with Robco in Munich. So these are the hard things, because software is so much easier. So the hardware part of baking lasagna, great batteries, is really hard. So how about the scaling? So maybe take us about 2 or 3 years down the road. So what are you planning with InoBat?
The goal with InoBat is really to become number one European player for high performance applications, aviation and, you know, ultra high performance market. The goal is to go from aviation to space. You know, that's why I love that you have invested in another great company. And by the way, thank you for what you're doing for the European ecosystem. I know you are called the German Elon Musk, and I think Europe needs that bravery, especially with people investing their own money. Also, the forgiveness to founders who, you know, who have not delivered according to expectations, still giving them second, third chance.
Expectations not from the founder side, because things can fail through market, yes, or whatever, but the founders have delivered, yeah, but sometimes you fail, like Lilium. I believe this was not the fault of the founders. So yeah, things happened, yeah, but yeah, if the founders delivered, let's give them a second chance in a different area.
And I'm glad, you know, you're looking at it like Silicon Valley investors, even though in Europe that, you know, failing is just another way of learning things, you know, to do things better in the future. And Europe needs this mindset, you know, it needs to be encouraged. It needs to be encouraged to try and fail and learn and to do it better, rather than sort of, you know, putting a lot of like shame basically, you don't see many founders trying to start all over again in Europe. In US, it's expected. So I diverged, but basically to answer your question, yes, our goal is to inspire more innovation in Europe. You know, it's very difficult because the European mindset doesn't encourage taking risk. You know, scale up. We have seen that after the demise of Northvolt, the equity market completely dried up. You know, yeah, when I speak to investors now in Europe, they say, oh, you're too capital intensive. Of course, we're capital intensive because it's deep tech, it's hardware, right? It's a new industry.
But so it's also, there are a lot of cash flows waiting for you. So
absolutely.
You're already planning a big expansion here. You have the customer base, so.
Yes, we, you know, especially with this switch, with this bigger focus on European defense market, we have developed a new product. Mm-hmm. So we have taken the learnings from the human drone technology that has been developed for eVTOLs, and we are using the same technology, but in a smaller format for the drone applications, for the unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs, and we bring it as a European solution to a number of customers. And I'm, you know, very excited about it, you know, because to make an impact, you don't necessarily need to have a 20 gigawatt hour factory. You actually need to have a facility that can revolutionize the industry. You know, when you start putting people into the air, do air taxis, replace drones in Europe that have been traditionally powered by Chinese, you are enabling a major industry transformation. You know, yeah, it's a new supply chain, it's new job creation, and I think this is important. You know, you start small and you scale up fast, and this has been always the mantra of InoBat. Don't play too big, you know, too big gigafactories, but really prove yourself. This is one of few operational facilities in Europe, and then build from there, adapt or die, you know, so we're adapting to where the needs are.
That's great here that we have the R&D in directly besides the production, and then you have the facility in the space to grow the production. So looking forward for the future of InoBat and the support where I can so that we grow and get a real production and technology built in Europe, that you also become a lighthouse for other founders to build a great company. So it was great visiting you today. Thank you very much.
Vielen Dank für Ihre Visit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm forgetting my German, yeah, but yeah, thank you. And also thank you for supporting the European ecosystem. We need more Franks, talents of the world. And you know, this considered your second home in Europe.
Thank you very much.
Tech innovation. Thank you.